Good evening, students. In this video, I am going to discuss the last chemical property of alkyl halide, that is elimination reaction. Elimination reaction. Elimination reaction. That is, elimination means it's a removal of reaction. Dehydrohalogenation. Elimination reaction is nothing but here it's a dehydrohalogenation. See here. You read only this much. Hydrohalogenation. Hydrohalogenation means the addition of hydrogen and addition of halogen. Hydrohalogenation means addition of hydrogen, addition of halogen. Dehydrohalogenation means removal of hydrogen and removal of halogenation. Removal of halogen, that is elimination reaction. Here in elimination reaction, we are taking one important statement. That statement is called as Sedgers rule. Sedgers rule, or it is also called as Zetsu rule. So before going to take an example for elimination reaction, so let me discuss about first what is the Sedgers rule or what is the Zetsu rule. Listen here. If dehydrohalogenation of haloalkene can yield more than one alkene, if it gives more than one alkene, then the major alkene will be the highly substituted alkene, is called as the major alkene. I'll repeat the statement. If dehydrohalogenation of haloalkene can yield more than one alkene, the major alkene will be highly substituted alkene. Andra one haloalkene tagondo neevenadru dehydrohalogenation madidirappa andra ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವು ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೈನರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅವಾಗ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಯಾವ್ದು ಇರ್ತದಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೈಲಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಏನು ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಕನ್ಫರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೈನರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೀ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ಚೈನ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ದು ಚೈನ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್. ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಚೈನ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ಮೈನರ್ ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್. ಸೊ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್, ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದರ್ ಚೈನ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ whether this is a major alkene or whether this is minor alkene like that. So based on this Sedgers rule or Zetsu rule, I'll take one example. So let me repeat Sedgers rule or Zetsu rule. If dehydrohalogenation of haloalkene can yield more than one alkene, the major alkene will be highly substituted alkene. Okay, so if you want to carry dehydrohalogenation, you need to have one dehydrohalogenating agent. And here in this example, I'll take dehydrohalogenating agent is alcoholic potassium hydroxide is dehydrohalogenating agent. Here I'll take one example, then we'll come to know what is Sedgers rule or Zetsu rule. Okay, see, I'll take one haloalkene here. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH, CH3, and here I'll write a Br. This is one haloalkane it is, and the name of haloalkane is here 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So the name of haloalkane is, second position Br is there, so it is 2-bromo, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon atoms are there, so 2-bromo-pentane is the haloalkane, or you can call it as a alkyl halide. When this alkyl halide or haloalkane or 2-bromo-pentane reacts with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, alcoholic potassium hydroxide, it gives two alkenes, or it undergo a dehydrohalogenation, gives two alkenes. See here, so first alkene, so dehydrohalogenation means first I have to remove hydrogen atom, dehydro. So see here, one H from this CH2 and OH from KOH, this H and this OH combines to form H2O. So now removal of hydrogen takes place in the form of water. Then removal of halogen, I have to remove one halogen. Halogen is this one. This is halogen electronegative, and this one is K, is a electropositive. This K and this Br combines to form KBr. So now dehalogenation takes place in the form of KBr. Now the reaction, now the major alkene, the alkene will be like this: CH3, CH2, CH, it is, I have removed one H, therefore it becomes double bond. Here it is double bond. Then this is a CH, next is CH3. This is a alkene. This one is alkene, single bond is there, pentane, and this is a alkene because this carbon-carbon double bond is there. Then name of this alkene, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So second position double bond is there, so 2, 5 carbon atoms are there, 2-pentene is the name of alkene. Then one more possibility is there. Now this time I'll remove H from this CH3. H and this is OH combines to form H2O. Plus next I have to remove one halogen. So K plus this is Br. So KBr. Now the alkene will be like this: CH3 single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond CH. Here it will become double bond, it is CH2. It is also alkene. Now numbering, we'll decide the name: 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So now the name of alkene is, it is one first position, so 1-pentene. Here it is 2-pentene and it is 1-pentene. Both are alkenes. So among these two, one should be major alkene and that should be minor alkene. So according to Schedzeb's rule, if an haloalkane can yield more than one alkene, the major alkene will be highly substituted alkene. So highly substituted alkene is this one. Across the double bond, LHS and RHS chain is somewhat lengthy, therefore this is a major alkene. This is major alkene and this one is minor alkene. So 81% product will be, so 2-pentene, and remaining 19% will be, so 1-pentene is the product. So very important reaction, very important statement also. Most of the time in examination they have asked question based on Schedzeb's rule. Okay, so here I have taken 2-bromo-pentane and in question paper they have asked 2-bromo-butane like that. So if it is 2-bromo-butane, then here you will get 2-butene and here it is 1-butene, and the major product will be 2-butene like that. Okay, so make statement perfect. If dehydrohalogenation of haloalkene can yield more than one alkene, the major alkene will be highly substituted alkene. So for that statement, this is one best example. I hope it is clear. Thank you.